Mikey, you know, with close to 50 years of playing and commentating on this sport, what would you say has changed for the better?
First of all, I don't think it's close to 50 years. I don't want to feel that old.
Well, I meant when you first took up
yeah,
the ball.
Yeah, I understand. I think one of the most important things as far as changes in the game are concerned, is the fact that a lot of people are now a lot fitter playing the game of cricket. Yeah, even watching the game and the games recently that India have played in the one-day series, you can see the high level of fitness of the Indian cricketers. In the 50s, 60s, 70s, the Indian cricketers were nowhere near as fit as that. And I think it's a general thing that you are seeing throughout the game. Everybody has gotten a lot fitter. Everybody has hit the gym a lot stronger. And I think that has improved a lot of things in the game.
What would you roll back if you could? What changes have been not necessarily for the better?
Well, what I don't particularly like is the amount of cricket that is being played now. I think it is being watered down. I think there's just too much cricket being played. Years gone by, people used to look forward to a test series. I think test series are going on now and people even aren't aware that there's a test series going on because there's cricket being played somewhere almost every day of the year. And I think that is the one aspect of it that I'm not all that happy with. People will say, okay, the game is spreading. That means more and more teams are playing. You've got to find ways of fitting them in. But as an old fogey, I like to hear about a test series and looking forward to it and then thinking, okay, when's the next one coming up? Instead of two and three test series going on all at the same time and so much cricket being played that people have to think about rotation of the people in the team and when people get injured, how long it takes for them to come back. I don't think that is lifting the quality of the cricket.
How much did World Series cricket change things? I remember reading in your book, for example, that it was the first time you saw four digits in your bank account.
Yeah, well, that wasn't a big thing. As a matter of fact, if it wasn't for Kerry Packer and World Series cricket, I wouldn't be sitting here now. I certainly would not have become a professional cricketer, and I would perhaps have gone off and gotten a 9-to-5 job. In fact, when World Series cricket started, I was at the University of the West Indies, given a scholarship by the then Prime Minister, Mr. Michael Manley. And I was pursuing some other job. I was doing computer science and looking forward to working a regular 9-to-5 job.
But when, a lot of batsmen wish you had pursued.
Yeah, perhaps a lot of batsmen are sorry now that Kerry Packer came along. But I think Kerry Packer changed not just my life, he changed the game of cricket and he changed it for the better. At the time, there were a lot of people that were against him, a lot of people that were against the players who went to join Kerry Packer. I remember them calling us mercenaries and talking about the Kerry Packer circus. But I think looking back now, even the English cricket board, who were the most venomous against it, will look back and say it helped the game.
Test cricket. Administrators around the world are known for saying that test cricket is the main product, the primacy of test cricket. How do you square those statements with what you see as the ground reality right now?
It's just a lot of talk. From what I can see, administrators just keep on talking, but the actions don't match the talk. It doesn't seem as if they are trying to preserve test cricket. It doesn't seem as if they are trying to make sure that test cricket is number one. It seems to me that they are having test cricket only because they think they can't get rid of it or they should not get rid of it. They are more inclined to think about games and forms of the game that bring in lots of money, the bottom line. And I'm not trying to tell anyone that money isn't important, the cash, the bottom line isn't very important to the administration of the game and the administrators. But you have to have a balance. And as far as I'm concerned, there is no balance in regards to the primacy of test match cricket.
The 2020 leagues have mushroomed around the world. I mean, every country you look at now has a facsimile of the IPL going on. Can you eventually see test cricket being squeezed out of the calendar apart from perhaps a marquee series like the Ashes?
I think, you know, Michael Atherton asked me a question similar to that a couple of years ago in England. He was writing an article and wanted my opinion as to what I thought would happen to test cricket. And he asked me if I thought test cricket would die in 20 years. And my opinion was that no, I don't think test cricket will die. I think test cricket will be still around, but it will get insignificant. It won't be anything that people will look forward to and want to go and play or want to go and see. I think what is happening now is that everyone wants to see the shorter form of the game because it's more exciting. When 50-over cricket came in, everybody gravitated towards 50-over cricket, and 50-over cricket brought in a lot of people who never watched test match cricket. those people, are some of those people, then started to watch Test match cricket because they were introduced to it by 50 over cricket. And everyone said 50 over cricket is the savior of the game. People got a little bit tired of 50 over cricket because they said, oh, 50 over cricket is so long, although initially it was the best thing ever. So they brought in 2020 cricket. And again, this is the best thing ever. Everybody is saying 2020 cricket is the savior of the game, and everybody wants their own domestic 2020, and that's bringing in all the money, bringing in all the new audiences. But as I've said to people, and I am yet to be, I'm waiting for them to prove me wrong, that the people that are attracted to 2020 cricket won't be attracted to Test match cricket. They won't then move on to Test match cricket as some of those who were attracted to 50 over cricket. And what I'll also tell people is that very shortly, people will be tired of 20 over cricket. They'll say it's too long, and you'll soon get 10-10. And then after that, perhaps 5-5. So I don't know which direction we're going to be heading in.
How can you incentivize Test cricket, Mikey? I remember doing some sums a few years ago when the IPL began, and Ishant Sharma was making as much money for bowling one IPL over as he did playing an entire season of Test cricket for India. So how do you expect players to prioritize Test cricket? How can we make it more attractive?
And prioritize Test cricket. If I was a young man today, I would go and play in the IPL. I would want to earn as much money as I possibly can in as quick a time as I possibly can. Anybody would do that, Dileep. Anybody who works anywhere in the workforce, if they are working 40 hours a week and getting $10, and somebody offers them a 20-hour week to earn $30, they're going to go and do the 10-hour week. It doesn't matter if it's a job that they don't particularly like. They're going to do the 10-hour week because it gives them more money, gives them more security, gives them longevity as far as their life and what they can do for their kids and all that is concerned. So I'm never ever going to blame any cricketer for wanting to play 2020 and want to earn the maximum amount of money in the quickest amount of time. I blame the administrators. Just as you look at families, I don't blame kids for being truant. I blame the parents. So I blame no cricketer. I think the administrators are the ones who need to look at what is going on and grab a hold of it and before we lose it.
Where do you stand on the Test Championship? Do you believe there's a future in the Test Championship, or do you think it's a very artificial sort of construct where you have a one-match playoff in neutral conditions which no one's really interested in?
Championship makes sense. When I heard about it initially, I wasn't in agreement with it. I didn't think it would make sense. And apparently it is still born. I'm not too sure if they're going to try and revive it at some point. But I don't think it makes sense. I don't think you can have a Test Championship over such a long period of time and then end up with one Test match. Wherever that Test match is, there's a possibility of bad weather or a drawn Test match. So you have to spend all this time building up towards a Test match that's supposed to be proving the best team in the world and then end up with a draw. I don't really believe in that. If you're going to have a Test series, fine. But again, that's going to be spread over such a long period of time. By the time you get to the finals, the team that started 3-4 years ago might be a different team. So you're talking about a Test nation, not a Test team. And I don't really believe in that.
Coming to the West Indies in Test cricket, there was a time when West Indies cricket was the biggest draw card in the game. You were invited to Australia pretty much every year to either play one-day internationals or Test cricket. I think the last time West Indies played a 5-Test series in Australia was in the year 2000, if I'm not wrong.
I'm not sure.
And the series are getting shorter and shorter. They don't get long tours of England anymore either. So how much do you think that's affected cricket in the Caribbean? The fact that, you know, the popularity of the team, if you like, has gone down.
I don't think it's that has affected cricket in the Caribbean. And I think that's a general direction in which cricket is going. You know, the only teams now that are getting 5-Test matches are the Ashes, which is England, Australia, and of course teams that India play against. And that's all because of finance where India is concerned. Not because they think it's going to be a great series, because we have seen India go on tour and get beaten 4-0 and 4-1 and 5-0. And that cannot be a great series. But it's financially viable to play that many Test matches against India. Apart from that, you're going to see more and more 3 and 2 test series. We just had a series in Dubai with 2 test matches. Australia versus Pakistan. Those are supposed to be 2 good teams. That could have been a great 5-test series. But we only had 2. Again, because of just the direction in which Test match cricket is going. It wasn't financially viable to either team. So they played 2. And I think that's the general direction in which Test cricket is going.
That's it from us for part one of this fascinating discussion with Michael Holding. Join us for part two soon.